Hi, welcome back and thanks for joining me. My name is Tammy and today we're talking about conversions. We actually work through imperial and metric system quite fluidly. I mean, I've got a glass of wine here. The bottle came in mils, but I could definitely measure how many cups is in here. Although I don't really care, I'm going to drink it anyways. Sometimes, however, I actually do need to know how much is in my glass. So we're going to talk about conversions today and go through imperial and metric system. There is a free download of a conversion table and two free quizzes. Make sure you download those and meet me at the board. Okay, so I hope you've got your conversion table. For convenience, I do have some on the board here. Some of the more common conversions that we will see in our calculations, but not all of them. And I've underlined some of our imperial measurements in red. So let's go ahead and look at our first question. Convert 210 pounds into kilograms. Well, I know that pounds is a smaller unit than kilograms. And looking at my table, I see that 1 kilogram is equal to 2.2 pounds. I know from my conversion chart that when I am moving from a smaller unit to a larger unit, I'm going to divide. So 210 pounds divided by 2.2 pounds per kilogram, I cross off my pounds, complete the calculation, and I see that my answer is 95.45 kilograms. And that is moving between imperial from pounds into metric kilograms. Okay, so question 9 is asking us to convert 0.025 grams into micrograms. And I want to look at this question because there's actually two steps to this conversion. So I am moving from a bigger unit of grams to a smaller unit of micrograms, which means I'm going to be multiplying. So in looking at my conversion chart, I can see that 1 gram is equal to 1,000 milligrams. But I don't want milligrams as my end unit, I want micrograms. So I look at my chart again and I see that 1 milligram is equal to 1,000 micrograms. So let's go ahead and set up our equation now. Converting 0.025 grams, I'm going to multiply that by 1,000 milligrams per gram. You'll see that I can now cross off my grams. But I need one more step. I multiply further again by 1,000 micrograms per milligram, cross off my milligrams, and I now have my units isolated to micrograms. So I can solve this equation. 0.025 times 1,000 times 1,000 micrograms is equal to 25,000 micrograms. So the reason I picked this question is because there's multiple steps to this conversion. So I observe a fluid running at 10 drops every 15 seconds, and the tube itself has a drip rate of 10 drops per mil, but the question is asking me to calculate mils per hour. So right away, I know I've got to do a few things. The first thing is I have 10 drops every 15 seconds, and I'd like to calculate that into how many drops is in an hour so that I can get my hours established. So I know from my time conversion that there are 60 seconds in a minute. So I'm going to put this into my formula and cross off my seconds. I'm left with drops per minute, so I take another step further and it's 60 minutes in every hour. I can cross off my minutes and I'm now left with drops per hour. Multiply everything on the top and I get 36,000 drops. Multiply everything on the bottom and I get 15 hours. And I can continue to solve for this and I get 2,400 drops per hour. Now that's just the first step. The second thing is I need to convert those drops into mils. In my stem question, I see that my tube has a drop factor of 10 drops per mil. I'm going to use that to solve my equation. So I'm going to take the value of 2,400 drops per hour, and I'm going to multiply that by the relationship of 1 mil is 10 drops. So I can cross off the drops, I'm left with mils per hour, and now I can go ahead and solve for the equation. I get 240 mils per hour, and that satisfies the question. Well, now that supper's cooking, I'm going to find out how many mils this glass holds. Until next time. That's good.